Alrighty. Well, mission today, we're going to split this hive here. We're over at my mom's house. I'm limited. I can only keep two hives here because I'd just stress her out too much if I had more. But two very productive hives. You can see all the bees. They'd have probably sworn by now, but being they're buck fast, you get a little extra time. Buck fast are never in a hurry to swarm. So those are Italians or carnies, they'd be gone by now. But I don't know if you remember that video we did, them coming out of winter. This one was really, really small. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab this one and take it home, or take it somewhere. And then we're going to split, move that queen over into this, because we're going to switch these boxes out. The bottom boards are getting rotted out and stuff, so plus it's 8-frame equipment. I'm going to go ahead and switch over to 10 here, seeing I can only keep two. Might as well keep them as big as possible. So I'm going to take this one, put it in a nuke box, transfer box, take it home, do something with it. I have no idea. See how they had that yeast infection last winter, but they battled through it. We're going to move this queen over here, and then I got a new queen. New queen here. New buckfast queen. And I put marshmallows, many marshmallows in the end, so it'll take longer for them to chew her out. She's already marked and everything, ready to go. So that's what we're doing. First, we're gonna kind of shaded, so I don't know. That should work. I don't know how they're gonna act, but I probably don't need to wear a veil, but I got it on them. Yeah, we may not be using them. So up down there. Nice frame of honey. Tell you what, this new recipe, I mean, this thing's been on there for a couple months. This new recipe, you don't get hive beetles in it. It's pretty cool. The old recipe used to get hive beetle larvae in it, but not with the new recipe. We can't talk about it yet, but eventually we will. I'm not allowed to say exactly what's in it. But big old frame of honey. Nice frame of brood. I mean, that was just a small cluster, remember? I never did boost them or nothing, so. I did give one strip of Apivar. Nice frame of brood. I couple more weeks, this thing would have rebounded pretty good here. Trying to find a queen. Got this side all laid up too. I put the cell in. I must have got the queen, I just didn't see her. One bird. Honey. Ooh, lots of honey. That's probably all autumn olive, I imagine. Nice looking frame for her to lay on. Let's stick that one in there. This is all larva. It's all wet brood. Definitely want that in the lower box. Fresh honey. They caught a pretty good flow last week. It's all fresh. Fresh nectar. Drones. Got a cloud of bees behind me here. Now we might do a change of plans there and just leave that queen there. I mean, if I can't find her, we'll just give her more room. Plenty of room. Off room. Got some wonky comb right here. It's about through the hay. Got eggs. Larva. Oh, wet larva. Not seeing any, for some reason. Get rid of it. Looks pretty nasty.
Much brood in here that I thought there'd be. I think they went through a supersedure probably. Because I know they didn't swarm. I'm not seeing any swarm though. But that's what happened. I'm not seeing sealed brood. We're not seeing sealed brood for some reason. Seeing some wet larva. They're definitely making honey. I don't know. See the larva, right? Something happened. Supersedure or something. But you got a larva right there. I got any. So I guess there's a queen. I bet you it's a new queen. I bet you, bet you, bet you. Yep, that's what it is. Got a new tool. So, I guess we won't be doing that. Change of plan. That's alright, we can change our plan. Something happened. because there should be some sealed brood in there. There's definitely a queen in there. Somewhere. Probably a young one. We got steel brood in that one over there. We're going to catch a heck of a flow this week. I know we are. Flow. We got yellow sweet clover started and black locust. There's two, there's a deep and a, yeah, that should be plenty. So much for the split. Look, we got the boxes changed and he's laying and laying eggs and got a big flow coming. There's a good sized population. I mean, I don't know if you want to look how many bees are behind us in the air. That's just one colony. Most of them are out foraging. We got them all backed up. So what I'll do is I'll just put that colony back. Looked like it was doing pretty well. I mean, all it needs is a good hatch. So we'll put that one back and clean up this mess. We'll have everything in this 10 frame equipment at least. It will be ready to go. This hive's gonna make big honey this summer. But anyway, I think that's about it. Thanks for watching. I was really impressed with the mite counts.
I did some oleic acid tests where I hit them with 4 grams of oleic acid vapor and put a drop cardboard balloon. We didn't find anything. So that we hit them early March with that Apivar, and it just annihilates them. That is definitely a key. Apivar is a wonderful thing, but you got to use it right, you know. If you put it on this time here with a bunch of boxes on, it's not going to work. Put it on early spring, I mean, like, as soon as you can get into them, it just knocks them back. So, I've been digging through everything, and I haven't seen a mite. You know, when you run across the drones, you know, you dig through them, and just nothing. Yep, anyway, beautiful day. Everybody have fun. Wow, that was a long video. All right, guys, take care. Ladies, thanks for watching. Hooterville Honey's out.